Anybody here pay rates? Now this applies across the board with things like rates and social charges, all the stuff the councils are trying to take off of you. I believe Dublin City Council are here today, eh? Well, good information. Okay. This is what we've discovered. Okay. Rates. Anybody pay rates? Social charges, water charges, blah, all those charges, yeah? Okay. Who here can read that? Can you see that? Anybody read it out? Contract invoice demand. Now, I know some people have already seen this before. Okay. I know that my child can actually tell the difference between those three words. And most children can. Okay. What is it that a child can see as being the most obvious difference between those three words? The three words are demand, invoice, and contract. What is the most obvious difference between the three words that a child can see? Come on, shout it out. It's in red. That's obvious, but it's not the most obvious thing. It's underlined. That's obvious, but it's not the most obvious thing. It's larger. It's in bold. That's very obvious, but it's not the most obvious thing to a child. What is the difference, James? Okay. The difference is, and I won't hold you in suspenders any longer. The difference is, all three words are spelt differently. Yeah? You get it? Why are they spelt differently? They have? Somebody said it? Because they have three different meanings. Different words are spelt differently because they have different meanings. It's very simple, isn't it? You see, we're just simple lay people. We're just simple lay people. Okay? We like simplicity. We like things to be straightforward. Does anybody know what the legal definition of a demand is? When a guard stops you on the road and says, "I demand your name." Is there any guards here? I'm not being disingenuous towards the guards. I'm just giving you a funny example. Okay? What is the legal definition of the word demand? It's a request. Has anybody ever received demands from the council for something? Anybody? Hands up. A few, okay? For demands, for rates, or for charges, or whatever it might be. So now it puts it into a slightly different context. It'd be like getting a wedding invitation from a couple that you don't like. What would you do with it? You'd politely send it back. You'd respond, wouldn't you? You'd be honourable. You'd respond. You'd say, "Thanks, but no thanks. I'm busy that day." Okay? So, it's their request. So when the council or the corporation send you a demand, it's legally... I didn't make this up, lads. This somebody else made this up. It's in the law books. They made it up. That's their definition of demand. It's a request for payment or a request for something. So when you've received a final demand, that's great, isn't it? You won't be getting another one. That's the end of it. It's logic. You'd be writing to them and say, "Thanks very much for your final demand. Please find it enclosed." Yeah. Maybe you will, maybe you won't, I don't know. So the word demand, it actually said, I'll read it out, and you can look this up. I got this out of Black's Law Dictionary 2009. Demand, a request for payment of a debt or an amount due. And it has other similar words, or analogous, I think the word is, similar words. A demand is a request, a demand is a claim, a demand is a requirement, you are required, a demand is to seek. Very nice, pleasant words. So demands aren't as aggressive or abrasive as people perceive them to be once you know a little bit about the law. Okay. Now, who here has received a signed, validated invoice from the council? Anybody? An invoice, it's a good question. This man just asked me what I mean by that, and I'm assuming he means what you mean by the word invoice. So the word invoice here is defined. This is not my definition, lads, this is what it says here. An itemized list of goods or services furnished by a seller to a buyer. An itemized list of goods or services from a seller to a buyer. Makes sense, doesn't it? Somebody does some work for you or does something for you. They send you an invoice. If they've done what you've asked them to do, a bit like Moody's and Standards and Poor's and Fitch's, you'll be paying them, won't you? But they'll itemize the work they've done, they've carried out. If there's something on that list that they haven't done, you're going to challenge it, aren't you? When was the last time you got an invoice from the council? Anybody here get an invoice from the council? An invoice for water. Did they say how much water you used? Oh, that's good. And you've paid it, obviously. Okay, that's fine. That's fair enough, isn't it? Now, did you have this man here, just clarify, you got an invoice from the council for water charges. And they itemized your use, how much you used, la 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 la, so on and so forth, and he paid it. Okay, now, question for you. For those people that have received invoices, and hands up who's received an invoice, as we've defined it, a list of goods and services that you've used, water. Anybody else received invoices for anything else? Bins. Other than water?
Bins.
What?
Bins.
Bins. Okay, so you've no problem paying for the goods and services that you use, because you're all honourable people, isn't that right? Okay. Anybody receive a rates demand? Some people have. Have you received an invoice for the rates? Okay.
A bill.
And is it down as an invoice bill or a bill?
Bill.
A bill. Have they listed out the goods and services that they have provided on that bill? No. So they haven't met with the legal definition of what an invoice is. So why don't you simply ask them for an invoice then? To break down the goods and services that you have received. Okay, now, another question for yourself. I know we've talked before. You've received an invoice for the water rates, for the water charges, whatever it might be. And they have listed them down, the cubic usage and all the rest of it. Do you have a contract with the council for the provision of said goods and services? Have you signed a contract? Okay. Right. Are you sure? You keep saying no, he hasn't signed a contract, by the way, for the record. We won't put your name on the camera either. Okay. Has anybody here received and agreed and signed a contract with the council for rates or charges, whatever they call them, social charges or water charges or gas, or whatever it is they think they provide? Anybody receive a contract in draft? No? Now, this goes back to, and we're getting into contract law in a minute, and I probably want Kieran to help me out in a minute. When I worked for 15 years or so in the UK in the construction industry. And as a junior planner stroke engineer, one of my jobs for a period of 6 or 8 months was to examine contracts on behalf of my boss. Okay. So as a planner, I would sit down and we'd have things like, there'd be a draft contract, there'd be preambles, there'd be specifications, there'd be bills of quantities, and probably one or two other documents. And they're all very, very, they're all very, very clearly defined documents. Because you know why? Do you know how I knew what a contract was? It was wrote on it. Yes. Who said that?
Come on up to the top of the class.
Hey, give him a hand. Give him a round of applause. That's it. It was wrote on it. The word contract was wrote on it. And when we were looking at bills of quantities, the word bills of quantities was on the front sheet. And same with the specification, same with the preambles, and the same with the contract. How do you spell contract? C-O-N-T-R-A-C-T. So when somebody said to me, did you look at the contract? It was a very simple question, yes or no. So I spent about 6 or 8 months looking at these things, because we had to look at the contract to see if there was anything in the contracts that we didn't agree with. Okay? Very important document. Then I went, left the UK, came back to Ireland in 2002, and started working for a builder here. One of the bigger builders in the country. And again, I was looking at this stuff, all the paperwork. So I then decided to get into buying a bit of property. And I sourced property, I don't know where it was at the time, probably Carlow or someone like that. And I sourced the property, then I went to a mortgage broker, and the mortgage broker had on his team a solicitor, and he obviously was in touch with the bank, blah, 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 blah. So I went to the mortgage broker and said, look, I'm buying this yoke here. Remember the yokes we were talking about on the screen? And can you sort me out? And he said, yeah, no problem. And he got a solicitor, and the solicitor sorted out some of the paperwork. And then the solicitor then, I said, look, send me on the paperwork, and I'll have a look at it, and I'll bring it back, and so on and so forth. Because I'd been used to looking at contracts. Okay, I thought, I'm great, like, I can look at contracts. I wasn't as great as I thought. So the solicitor, anyway, I think she faxed over this so-called contract, and it said on it, terms and conditions. I thought, that's strange. Why doesn't it say contract? Okay, so I brought it home anyway. I thought, well, I went through it. And what I did was, I went through every word in it and every page. And as was my job before, I highlighted stuff, I put lines through stuff, I edited stuff, I added pages in, I took pages out, I put lines across it and red mark and ink and all this all over the place. I think every page had something on it or something removed from it, and I had additional stuff in, because some of the terms and conditions I just didn't agree with. It was that simple. Brought it back the next day, faxed it off to the solicitor. I actually found a little bit of paperwork from her there the other day. I was going to bring it along today. So, I'm glad I didn't. So, within an hour of sending this fax back to the solicitor with this apparent set of terms and conditions or contract, whatever it was, I got a call. And she said, I won't swear, I promise. She said, who the do you think you are? Who the do you think you are? I said, what? This woman was swearing at me down the phone. She said, who the do you think you are? I said, I didn't swear. Will you stop standing behind me? The cameraman doesn't like it. Okay, so she then proceeded to say, if you want this money, if you want this mortgage, if you want to get that house, you better sign this document and forget about all that stuff about editing it and changing it and putting in your own stuff. That's ridiculous. That's not the way we do business in Ireland. How dare you? Well, you see, her fee was on the line, you see. And she didn't want to go back to the bank with this thing all written up. She didn't want to draft a contract and put it to the bank. Because what I was doing was, I was engaging in what I thought was, you know, open terms and conditions and what I wanted on the contract and blah, blah. Now, I didn't change a hill of beans, but I changed enough so that it wasn't all just one-sided. Well, she proceeded then to browbeat me over the phone, and you wouldn't think it was possible. Well, it wouldn't be possible now, but back then it was, because I was in a place where I think I wanted the money, and I think I wanted the property, and I think I wanted this. It was my sort of internal greed. So I facilitated her browbeating me, but what she did was actually illegal as well as unlawful. And I felt that big by the time she'd finished. I said, okay, fax it through again, I'll sign it. And, okay, it's called coercion, is that the word? Mm-hmm. Okay. That's what I did, went off. Then I was off in a hack. Everything that came through, so easy. Okay. Piece of cake. Don't tell me a joke about that. That was fine, that got me off to a start anyway. Now, we get into contract law.